I am Nischita and my topic for the thesis project is a residential school named Arambh Vasati Vidyalaya. The project was born from the idea of the influence of architecture and characteristics of spaces on human beings and from the fact that most of us actually spend a good deal of time in various educational institutions as education is considered to be an important part of our lives. This project aims to create a learning center supported by residential facilities in Jamkhandi, Bagalkot district. The design will take into consideration mainly the requirements of students only. Thus, the design with respect to the requirements of the teachers becomes a limitation. Today, in Jamkhandi, the town that is titled as the educational hub of the district, 60 to 70% of the students head out to avail a good educational facility, as there exists a very minimal number of schools that mainly teach in Kannada and Urdu languages. This also becomes a difficult economic situation, and the lack of financial resources is a significant barrier to the enjoyment of children's fundamental rights. Hence, the proposed school would cater to children in Jamkhandi and smaller villages around. The town lies in the dry and arid zone and experiences hot summers and cold winters. The rainfall is low and the season lasts for 3 to 4 months. As a result of its climatic conditions, the region has a very sparse distribution of natural vegetation. Some of the commonly found are Kadle Mullu, Catweed or Crafton Weed, Jali Mara, Kadu Sampige and Gulmoha trees. The most commonly used building material in the region is the red sandstone, mainly due to its availability in abundance. Clay bricks are manufactured in and around the region, and also Shahabad stones are readily available from the neighboring Kalaburgi district. The project sits on the site that covers an area of 105,748 square meters. Located between its town center and Hulyal village, the school is situated on level topography with views to the surrounding hills north and east. Jamkhandi Mudol Highway from within the town center leads to Hulyal village main road, which further helps one to reach the site. Shambhulingeshwara temple, Jamkhandi jail, Jamkhandi RTO and fire station are all in the immediate context of the site. Existing vegetation identified as Gulmoha trees, Castabean trees, Mahogany trees, Legume trees are all retained or replaced for shading. One can feel a slight downward slope upon walking from the northeast to the southeast side of the site. The site gets hit by the harsh sun from the southwest direction for most part of the year and receives wind with maximum velocity from mostly southwest and western side. Looking into some existing school designs for better understanding, first is Tumbil School and PU College, a design by architect Shashi Bhushan. Located in a dry region, Vijayapura has very similar climatic and cultural conditions as Jamkhandi. The design is inspired by the historical domes that grace Vijayapura and responds well to the climate. Use of locally available resources, techniques adopted to enhance indoor space quality, and the structure itself are all worthy of attention. Moving on to the next case, Mysore Public School gets its design elements from characteristics of where it's located, the heritage city Mysuru. This case is explored mainly to understand the functioning of a residential school. The design is notable for how the flow of spaces has resulted in a good built-open relationship and for it is done keeping children and their safety in mind. Under literature case studies, first comes CMR Akia School. It is known for its well-thought and designed spaces by architect Sanjay Mohe. The design involves various techniques adopted for better thermal comfort, like the use of wind tunnels and a play of volume and light to make the spaces more interesting. The design also exhibits a good combination of rigidity and looseness in spaces that gives a user better choice of freedom. Lastly, we have Yellow Train School. The firm Biome Environmental Solutions has created the school for Waldorf system of education in the hot climate of Coimbatore. This case was looked upon mainly to know how the different systems of education require different approaches to design. Learning areas that allow multiple activities to take place in them and the spaces created to ensure an undisturbed routine of play are notable. School design generally targets a fixed group of users, mainly students and the ones that teach them, who become the primary set of users. However, there are other users too who work towards ensuring the smooth running of the school, and these are the secondary users. Based on the understanding of what are the activities carried out by these identified sets of users, a list of academic and non-academic spaces is made. These spaces put together gives the required building blocks. Further, the user-space relationship and the proximity of spaces are understood from these matrices. Based on the understanding of user-space relationship and proximity of spaces, two options for zoning of spaces are created. The list of identified spaces are numbered as shown. The first option shows sports facilities distributed all over, academic blocks confined onto the northern side, and services and residential blocks placed on the rear end of the site, while the second option clearly marks zones of sports, academics, residential facilities, leisure, and services that are spread out evenly on the site. A small area of land is considered for future expansion, as schools generally plan on including provision of higher education as well. Furthermore, all the spaces required are listed and areas are calculated. The site area, as mentioned previously, is 105,748 square meters, and the total built-up area comes to 13,562 square meters, which achieves an FAR of 0.12. The allowable FAR is 1.5, and a ground coverage of 55% is permitted. Desire for visually strong objects occurs hierarchically, starting first above the level of survival and graduating higher, like cooking for everyday food and for feast, or clothes for everyday and for special occasions. Can we avoid this trend of consumption and yearning for monumentality in architecture of everyday life at least? Schooling is one amongst all other important everyday activities. We all go to schools every day and it has become a second home. So the basic concept for the project is an everyday architecture that is essentially purposeful and could relate to the commonness of local life, yet with aesthetics of its own, not dominated by visuals alone, and need not necessarily be banal or pedestrian. Architecture then can derive its purpose in its engagements with users. In order to strengthen the basic ideas, a better understanding of such concepts is necessary. Following are two such studies that have helped in making a way ahead for this design project. First is the case of New Bagalkot Design by Charles Correa, where he has worked with modules and strips to form the whole new planning. The reasons for the choice of this example are mainly its location, which has similar climatic conditions as Jamkandi, and to check how openness and design in such hot and dry areas work. Important takeaways from the study are, first, the courtyards work fine in such regions, provided there's a thought given on ways to avoid dust from entering the spaces. Second, through a connection to the sky comes the possibility of natural light and air, along with the benefits of improved environment and health. Moving on to the next study done to understand the importance of unbuilt spaces in institutional buildings, the takeaways here would be, in the context of institutional buildings, the built form signifies rigidity of function and formality of organization, while the unbuilt spaces become areas of recourse and social interaction. The open spaces are areas of optional usage, and hence their design, location, and organization are of utmost importance to enhance the overall quality of the built environment. Hence, the built spaces signify the purpose of the built form, whereas the unbuilt spaces signify the spirit of this place. The site planning is done in accordance with zoning option 2, which was shown previously. The identified building blocks are carefully placed and evenly spread on the site. An axis that separates the academic zone sitting on the southern end of the site from all else can be noticed. The basic idea for the academic zone was to create a bonding amongst the children of different ages by placing them three blocks in close proximity such that they open out to one another easily. The residential blocks require safety and privacy, hence the hostel block is placed on the rear end. But the faculty housing sits on the front end of the site to create a gap between their professional and personal lives, to give the families their own privacy and an easy access to the outside world. Spaces for leisure come together to form a zone of their own on the northern end of the site. The basic idea that holds good for most of the spaces in the project is having a central open court and building blocks sitting around it. And also for the roofs, the idea comes from the fact that we all live in our own tiny world created within the bigger world. This holds good for the administration block as well. The spaces are placed around the central courtyard such that cross ventilation is ensured in each of them. The sections show the vaulted roof created in accordance with the basic idea narrated. The building gets its own shield from harsh sun, that is, a screen wall has been erected to avoid the direct hit from the sun. The wall is designed using locally available materials from in and around Jamakandi, which makes up the idea of a design as part of everyday culture. A simple grid formation with patterns created using the materials has resulted in a craft. The height of the wall varies all along its length to make it look more interesting. The open-air theatre here in this context is not only used for performances but also as a socializing space, a play space where kids simply enjoy jumping from one level to another. Hence, the thought behind the design was to not make it like any other open-air theatre which goes with the usual standards, but to play with levels carefully to make it more interesting and playful. Kindergarten block. The idea for this block comes from the understanding of how important play is in a child's life, its impact on child development. Above all, play is simply a joy that is cherished as part of childhood. But kids are to be monitored constantly. A boundary has to be laid around to avoid them from running here and there. Hence, the idea of creating a structure that speaks for itself and is symbolic of boundaries is seen. Looking into the space, wide corridors allow the learning to spill out from the closed learning environment. The central courtyard equipped with various games and trees for shade act as a protected play area for the little kids. This section shows an interesting method adopted to ensure cross ventilation in classrooms. Instead of having a single partition between the corridor and the classroom interiors, wind tunnels are added in between, which gives rise to two walls, one towards the corridor, the other with an opening as part of the classroom. The resulting stack effect helps in creating a better indoor comfort. Co-curricular activities block. Generally, in order to accommodate extracurricular activities, a multi-purpose hall is created in institutions where all such activities take place under a single roof. But here, an attempt is made to break down one large space into smaller pockets of spaces. Although it's a single building block, each pocket of spaces has its own roof. The sections show the dome roofing created to allow the movement of good amount of air as these spaces accommodate activities like dancing, singing, playing, etc., which are practiced in large numbers. The details show the techniques used to create domes as roofing and walls for extensions in the co-curricular activities block. As mentioned previously, the region experiences super hot summers. To counter this problem of heat transfer, the roof is designed with hollow clay blocks placed over steel ribs, which are then topped with a screed. This reduces heat absorption and transfer substantially. This technique is used for all domes and walls in this design project. The idea for primary block design simply goes with the classrooms being organized around a large court which can house students to sit around and even interact. The classrooms are made trapezoidal than the usual rectangular geometry. Both primary and mid and secondary blocks have their own libraries to cater to the needs of different age groups. There is a lecture hall placed on top of the library which has access at two levels, one being at the first floor level and the other placed at a higher level to avoid crowding at the time of the use of space. This is clearly shown in the section. One of the classrooms is considered and sections are cut to understand the technique adopted to induce stack effect and the two levels of vaulted roofing. Addition of wind tunnels is what achieves the stack effect, as explained previously in the kindergarten block. The roofs are vaulted with the use of hollow clay blocks and screed technique to counter the heat transfer. The mid and secondary block design is based on and is same as the primary block design. What happens within is all that changes here. A classroom there could be a language room here. The spaces have their own screening walls to shield themselves from the harsh sun. Most of the classrooms on the ground floor are open to the limited landscape space created with the addition of screen walls around. The screen walls shielding the classrooms are designed as shown. These walls are made up of composite materials. Exposed hollow clay blocks make up a frame of RCC cast in inside to support composite screens of bricks and Shahbagh grey stones. The stone plates cut to shapes fit within the frame of composite RCC and hollow blocks. The open to sky space between the classrooms and the screen wall could be covered by a pergola of poles or bamboos. A simple circular toilet block is created for both boys and girls. The drawing shown is the layout of boys' toilet. The urinals here are replaced by toilet seats in the girls' toilet block. The wall is built with the stone masonry and roofing is a simple butterfly truss topped with tiles and with a gutter in between. A single hostel block is divided into two halves to accommodate both boys and girls from grade 5 to grade 10. One of the reasons to have a single hostel block for both boys and girls is to create an easy way to understand the physical and biological changes that the kids go through at that point in time. Also, it creates a better bonding amongst themselves by being easily available for one another. Basic design idea here is also to have small open courts or wind tunnels for better lighting and ventilation. Common baths and toilets are provided in a separate block attached on either ends to ease out the services. Also, every floor has its own common rooms for fun and leisure, pantry and laundry. The section shows wind tunnels and walls used as roofing clearly. The roofing detail explains the construction technique used to beat the heat using hollow clay blocks laid on steel ribs and topped with screed. The staircase cover is also done the same way, but with added punctures in the roof surface to allow light to come in. The punctures are covered with a polycarbonate sheet on top. Although it is mentioned that the design sticks to the requirements of students alone, a simple planning for faculty housing is made. Faculty in such residential schools basically require a place for bed and bath. Hence, this simple shelter with small areas of living, pantry, bedroom, and bath is created to accommodate them. Moving on to the dining hall, it is one of the important spaces in the residential school. Generally, these are rectangular halls accommodating a large number of people in them. But an attempt is made to make the space slightly interesting with the use of dome as roofing and splitting the space in two levels. A small area is elevated to a height of 2.4 meters to accommodate those who wish to eat away from the noisy or crowded environment of students. The roof construction technique is same as seen in the co-curricular activities block. Conclusion. Designing a school deals with the energy of children of different age groups. There are endless number of ways to design comfortable learning spaces, trying out various permutations and combinations, experiment at such smaller projects, eliminating the formal methods. Imperfect spaces made interesting in its materials and the way of construction allow students of impressionable age to react. They may understand the value of design as something more than just banal repetition. They would even be reactive to their environment. Thank you. Thank you.